Thank you to everybody for inviting me to speak today, and thank you for everything that everybody here does to support those that need our help. Why do we need this help? Well, we need this help because there is a growing need. So if we chart our pastoral provision of families that require support, and that has gone up by about 25% over the last 3 years. I got stopped in the car park the other day, just going out of school to a meeting, by a mum who wanted to thank me for all of the help that we'd given to her before Christmas. And I say we, because it's many of the people sitting here who have managed to help her. She said, "I can't tell you what a difference it's made." And she said, "I've been a working mum," and she has, and I've known her for a long time. And she said, "I've never known it to be as hard as it is now." She started to cry while she was telling me her story, and she said, "I never thought I would get here. I never thought that this would be my life." And neither did I. I never thought that this would be my life. I never thought that as a head teacher, I would be having those conversations with people in a car park as I'm trying to get to another meeting. But I'm afraid that is my daily life at the moment. That is my daily existence. We have a system called CPOMS, which charts the problems, and we note everything down, and we note our responses to it. At least daily, there is another family popping up who is asking for help in terms of being able to meet their bills. So another mum came to talk to me, and she said, "I'm glad you're telling this story. I'm glad it's getting out, because I had to water my nut down with another pint of water, a pint of water too, so that kids don't know that I can't make ends meet." So she has to make decisions about whether she puts heating on, whether she cooks, or whether she washes children's clothes or not. So, before Christmas, we were approached to see whether we would take part in the film. We did, and then all hell because suddenly, the generosity of this wonderful country that we're part of was shown up in all of its glory, because our hall became an aid depot, as did West End School and several other schools in the area. We were literally swamped. I'm going to tell you what that means. There was a lady that phoned from Amsterdam who offered us £1,000 worth of a food order that she placed in one of our local supermarkets and was arriving shortly in the next 2 days. So we had 25 frozen turkeys, bags of potatoes, sprouts, and everything coming through the door. At the same time as that wonderfully generous act, another elderly gentleman came around from Silverdale with his turkey, which he said was too big for himself and his family, so he would like to give it to a family that needs that would benefit from it. The traveller community arrived with £300 worth of food on the first day, and then the second day arrived with a similar amount of money, again having been spent on new coats, new hats, new scarves, new gloves for us to distribute. At the same time as we were dealing with that, there were people just coming through the door constantly with bags of shopping, with "Will this help? Do you want these toys?" And it hasn't stopped. That it's a trickle at the moment, thankfully, because we couldn't cope with it much longer at that rate. Because there was so much support coming in, there was a big open meeting that was called in Morecambe. But over 300 people attended that meeting, for no other reason other than to help people who they've never met. Just before Christmas, when we're all feeling stressed, everybody felt that they wanted to do something. And I want to thank each and every person who took that time out of their busy schedule and cared for people that they've never met. That really restored my faith in humanity, I have to say. To see those acts of generosity and kindness on that scale was an absolute heartwarming experience. But we've got to build on it. We've got to make sure that in this next year, that all of that conviction and all of that desire to make things better becomes a coordinated social movement that helps to address all of those people who need our help and need it so urgently. So thank you for coming along today, and I want to say a really big thank you to all of our partners as well that work with us. There are so many unsung heroes within our community. But one of the big, one of our big partners is without that food bank. We know, just to know, that when that family arrives saying, I can't feed my children and I don't know what to do, just knowing that you're here and we can, we have a solution and we don't need to feel helpless. We're going to start looking now at uniform bags and making sure that children can always look presentable. Because for a child who lives in poverty, it isn't just not having their food, it's the poverty of experience that goes along with it. So those children can't go to a club, they can't join a football club or a football society, they can't join a gymnastic club, they can't go join the local swimming group. So those children are not only deprived in terms of what they eat during the day, but they're deprived in terms of their experiences and what makes them a whole person. And the fact that their life expectancy is something like 20 years less than other people within a 5 or 10 mile radius is just not acceptable. We're trying to join the community together to tie up the local area and take some responsibility for the local area. So we're having a meeting in school on the 31st. If any of you would like to be part of one of those projects, please come along in the morning to find out what you can do and how you can help. But for now, a really big thank you to all of you for doing everything that you do, but particularly to the food bank.